It's Madden NFL 23, and today's clash of conferences is just moments away. It's the Green Bay Packers and the Denver Broncos, and it's coming up next.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us at the foot of the Rockies, just west of downtown Denver at Empower Field at Mile High. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Green Bay Packers and the Denver Broncos. Brandon Gaughton alongside the one and only Charles Davis. And CD, lots of compelling storylines in a game like this. Let's take a look at some of the numbers for these two offenses.
And I'm glad you brought up the numbers, because sometimes it's hard to quantify a team's performance solely by judging the numbers. But I think with these two teams, what you see is a pretty accurate representation of who they are.
And he won't quite make it to the 25. So here are the Broncos now for their opening drive. They'll be led out by the man who proclaims to be from a whole pack of Badgers. Came into the league back in 2012, Russell Wilson.
And I think that even after a decade in the NFL, he doesn't get enough credit for not just his consistency, but his brilliant play and leadership as well. He's won a Super Bowl in Seattle. He's led his team to another Super Bowl opportunity also in Seattle. His numbers are always terrific, almost always in the Pro Bowl. And all his team does is win. This guy's a natural leader.
A little jet sweep to start the drive. That's a gain of 13 and a very solid opening play for this offense.
I think the reason this ball is successful is not just the blocking of the speed at which he takes the handoff. He's in motion already, so he's not coming from a flat start like a running back often is. He's at a full run by the time he gets the football.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Here's Wilson to throw. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
When you run in the slant, timing is everything. And against that man coverage, there was no space available, and incompletion as a result.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. From the gun, it's Wilson. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
Fourth down, Corliss Waitman now on to punt. He'll send this one into the mile high air, and it's a good one. That'll be a 44-yard boot, just a yard on the return as he's covered up quickly. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. Time to see the offense for Green Bay go to work. Aaron Rodgers leading them. What a career it's been. Came into the league back in 2005 as the number 24 pick out of Cal.
There have been very few quarterbacks in the NFL who have been as consistent throughout their career as Aaron Rodgers. He's been good for so long, and we've seen no decline in his skills. His accuracy and arm strength continue to elevate the talent around him, and his in-game mistakes, few and far between.
Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their own 17-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. And able to find Allen Lazard. Now it looks like we've got a Bronco that's banged up on the play. We'll step aside and get a report when we come back to Denver. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of two, third and one. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? It looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Here's Rodgers. And the Broncos get there and take him down. Randy Gregory charges in there hard and drops him for a loss of 12 from that outside linebacker position.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense, so he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of 4.
It's funny, throughout the time that we've been together when we talk with running backs about the ability to catch the ball, their eyes light up when they talk about open field and having one-on-one matchups, don't they?
Yeah, they do. And that's the reason why. What we just saw, shedding those tackles, and that's what they're used to doing.
It is, and it starts at the beginning of the play, one-on-one matchup of someone trying to cover them. But they also like those one-on-ones downfield after the catch when they're running with the ball. They think they're going to win those, too.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
Two things you can do in that situation. Run and punt the football or try to take your shot at getting the first down. They chose the latter, but they'll have to punt all the same.
So on fourth down, on is the punter, Pat O'Donnell, to kick it away. And it's fielded at the 34. They call that a punt of 38 yards officially. And the Broncos take over. First down and 10. So now the second drive offensively coming up for the Denver Broncos. Over on the sideline, hoping to hit that reset button between possessions. Last time out, they had to punt it away. This time, hoping to finish this thing off in the end zone. Good starting position for the Broncos here as they come up first and 10 at their own 42. They start the drive on the ground. It's Williams. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown. So a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game. Trying to establish the inside run. Run with toughness now. Hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
Williams going to get it again on second down. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Now they're going to be dealing with a 3rd and 7. Is that one officially a loss of 1?
Brandon, that's what you call being manhandled at the point of attack. And I know the offensive line gets a lot of blame for that one. But occasionally, the defense just knows what you're going to do. Maybe they scouted it perfectly. Maybe someone tipped it off. But on that play,
Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. Points 1, 2, and 3 in their defensive game plan was to get to the quarterback and knock the ball free. They did it there. Luckily, offense hangs on to it.
Yeah, that's got to serve as a wake-up call, though, because they can't afford to let the ball go over to the defense and miss opportunities. And I'm not saying it happened here, but you know what a good rule of thumb is when a play like that occurs? You know who usually recovers it? The guy who missed his block and let his quarterback get hit.
Here's Corliss Waitman now. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
How about that? Red man coverage and decided to test them early, but it proved up to the task and forced the incompletion.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. To throw is Rodgers. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
He's been giving some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit two of his first five passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
The threat of a second straight punt to start the game is looming as they come up third and 10. Now it's Rodgers.
Story of this game, but you absolutely have to like how this defense has played thus far. They have yet to allow this offense to get untracked in this one.
Here's Pat O'Donnell on now to punt it away. It's a 39-yard punt, three on the return. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. We've seen both of these offenses still sort of in that figuring things out phase, but I suspect some action on the scoreboard soon as they start out here first and 10. Here's Wilson. This one complete to Jerry Jeudy. And they'll get this down to the 42-yard line.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
First and 10, it's Wilson. Right back to Jeudy, and it's complete. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33. They still need about the length of the football here, maybe a little less, as they come up on second and inches. They give it to Williams, running right. And he works it to the 30-yard line here, right at the 30. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. And this one is incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone, and there was good coverage there to force the incompletion.
Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Now Wilson. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Rashawn Gary, now two sacks for him already here in this first quarter of play.
All about the offense so far this drive, putting something sustained together. But the defense, they responded on that play. Second and manageable became third and long. The drive marching to the end zone is one play from stalling out.
It's third and long now for Wilson and the Broncos after that sack. Looking to throw. Wilson. Buying time to his left. And unable to connect. Incomplete. I'll give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
Well, that was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
That's running out of steam, and it won't get there. He left it just short, no good, and this will remain a scoreless game.
And anytime you see a kicker trot out to try one for 56 yards, you know everything's got to come off perfectly for it to have a chance. If the laces aren't quite right, if he doesn't hit the fat part of the ball just right, it's unlikely to go through, and that one winds up no good.
The Green Bay offense ready to take over. And, partner, I know so far, and we're still in the first half, but you love this game as a defensive guy. 0-0. We'll see if the offense can get going on this drive.
Well, you know how they talk about music to your ears? How about what it does for your eyes when you watch something like this, right, where these teams are locked in and going at it, no points going up on the screen. You're exactly right.
Well, switch over, though, to an offensive mindset for a moment. What do they need to do here to get on track and get some points?
Well, I think a couple of ways. Number one, you pull out something maybe they haven't seen before. Coaches always talk about unscouted looks. Maybe you give them something that they haven't seen on tape, and now you shock them that way. The second, run your basic playbook, but run it so well that you give your skill position guys a chance to make big plays individually.
No score after one on EA Sports. The Packers with the football here to begin the second quarter as they've got it with a second and 10. Now Rodgers to the sideline, and that is a heck of a catch as he was able to get both feet in. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the touch.
And Nathaniel Hackett apparently disagrees with the ruling on the field, and he's going to challenge this one. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. The Packers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. A 3rd down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough.
Yeah, they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last 2 possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
Keep on the ground with Jones. He'll be stopped at the 35, but not before he picks up 7 yards.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Here's Rodgers to throw. Open man left side, it's the tight end, Tonyan. And he'll be brought down at the 27.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Now Rodgers. He's got the hook up to Lazard. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. A good-looking drive for the Packers so far. It's a 1st down.
Well, that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
So not quite a 1st and goal. It's 1st and 10 from the 10. They go back to the ground with Jump. And he lost the football. It's picked up by the Broncos.
Preseason, when we went to the different training camps and visiting teams, and we always would see the running backs working out and going through those gauntlet drills, and you know, guys either slapping at the ball or the machines. You gotta learn to take care of it.
Yeah, they lost it there, big fumble. So the Broncos coming out now. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah,
a little
closer.
Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Being chased, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Jaron Reed muscles his way in for the sack. So, Charles, no turnovers yet for this offense, but those sacks now, they're starting to pile up.
And one thing usually leads to another because they've got to figure out how the offensive line and everyone else involved in protection can keep their quarterback upright and allow him a chance to throw the ball downfield.
Throwing on 2nd and long. Wilson going with a screen for Murray. Give him 5 on the screen play, and that'll set up a 3rd down.
I wonder what was going through his mind when he got the play call. He just got sacked on the previous play. He knows they're coming after him again. A little bit of guts to stand in there, take the hit, and successfully complete the screen pass. Really well done.
A tall task ahead of him here, needing a full 15 yards to move the chains. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. He finds his man, complete. That's Murray. That's going to bring up 4th down, only a gain of 2 there.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked it down to force a fourth down.
Now we get to see the punter, Corliss Waitman. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And now a fair catch called for and taken just outside the 40-yard line. 37 yards on the punt with no return. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Packers offense set to go. And so close to hitting pay dirt last time, fumbling down near the goal line. Now, how does that affect their psyche this time around?
It's a tester, that's for sure, because to be that close and come away with no points is really disappointing, not just for the guys on offense, but the defensive players, too, who thought, hey, we can put some points up and have a little momentum going. They've got to find a way to just get it out of their minds, let it go,
short-term memory,
and move on to the next series.
So the completion results there in 9 yards, and it'll bring up a second and short. The middle, Jones, and he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. 48 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Rodgers now to throw. This one swung out here to Jones. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And it'll be second down.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way. And really, we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
To throw again on second down, Rodgers. He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. The pressure from multiple guys there as they bury him for a big 9-yard loss. It seemed like he kept going through those progressions, and I thought he might dunk that underneath, but he couldn't get rid of the football in time.
And I have to wonder if he was thinking while he was back there, I wish there were a lot less progressions on this play, just someone that I could dump the ball to and get it out of my hands. This is what you said.
Rodgers now, after the sack, he'll lead the pack up on third and long. Working from the gun, Rodgers. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Sometimes the game is pretty simple. Put a few extra defensive backs on the field, give them nowhere to throw the football, force the incompletion, and get off the field on third down.
Here's Pat O'Donnell now, as he's on to punt for Green Bay. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. They've been playing the field position game thus far. No score, second quarter, as they come up on first and 10. Now Wilson. Man open. He's got it complete to Cortland Sutton. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 14 yards that time for number 14. second quarter, 2 minutes to go, tie ball game. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Rashawn Gary able to get in there yet again. That's already three sacks for him here in this first half of football.
So that now four first half sacks. This pass rush has been unrelenting.
And partner, you hear that sound of paper being ripped to shreds? That's the game plan that they've had so far, because they've got to say to themselves right now, we have to do something differently.
They come up on second and long, and the pass protection just has not been there this afternoon. Another try after the first down sack. Wilson, and he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, partner, guaranteed they approach this play with the idea of making up ground to make third down manageable. Unfortunately, with that incompletion, right back where they started on the last snap. Now they need a big third down play in order to pick up the yardage needed.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now a give up the middle to Williams. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. The Broncos send out their punter now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return.
And they will take over first and 10.
The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here.
Tie ball game, still a little more than a minute to go in the half. The question, can they put something together here, try to take that lead into intermission?
I would have to think that would be the goal for sure. I don't think you sit on anything here. Here's your opportunity. Push it downfield. As you mentioned, it's a tie game. So minus a disaster on your part, you've got that in your back pocket. Go ahead and try and get some points and feel great going into the half.
Rodgers. And this one too low.
Well, partner, they're not content to run this one out as we head towards the half, trying to hit a big chunk play right there and add to their score.
Yeah, this is a confident group. At the very least, they're thinking field goal.
Yeah, and I don't blame them one bit. I don't think you sit on the ball going into the half when you have a chance to put some more points on the board.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. To throw, it's Rodgers. And now a fumble. The ball's out. It's picked up by the Broncos. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
The Broncos going to go on offense now late in this first half. And now they start in plus territory following that turnover, as they'll try to get some points here before halftime. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Following the fumble recovery, it's Wilson. On the slant, completes to Sutton. And they eventually get to him at the 17 after a pickup of 17 into the red zone, first down. It's Wilson. And his throw here is incomplete.
I'm seeing from this defense, because that has been playing at a shut down level so far, even backed up late. They're forcing incompletions and fighting to keep them out of the end zone as the first half winds down.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now it's Wilson. Open man Hamler, that's complete. And they're going to get this down inside the 15. Now the Broncos will use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Looks like the Packers have added an extra DB on third down. Throwing is Wilson. He's got a man. It's Sutton that's complete. And he's brought down. A good pickup, but it will come on what should be the final play in this first half. So plenty of action on the field, but no action right now on the scoreboard, at least as of yet. Nothing, nothing is our score. As now we send you out to Orlando and hook back up with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome everyone to our brand new studios here in downtown Orlando in the EA Sports Halftime Report. First up, though, a look at the next-gen stats for the Packers in that first half. And there's not much to speak of in terms of passing efficiency, but in a tie game, they know a few tweaks could make a big difference going forward.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. Scoreless first half, these teams now just looking for something as the second half gets underway. Nixon elects not to return it, and this comes out to the 25. The Packers ready to go to start quarter number three. And we thought this game had the potential to be tight, maybe not this tight, scoreless as we start the third quarter.
And I love the way you use the word tight. I'm going to take it a little bit different direction here because it's not just tight on the scoreboard. I think both offenses have been tight in how they've played this game. No one's been loose. No one's been free. They've got to find a way to make some plays, and I don't think you do it if you're really tight in everything that you're doing in the game.
Rodgers now on first down. And this is dropped. Oh, it's incomplete. He had a big gainer in his sights, but he could not reel it in.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about five or six plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
Throwing again on second and 10. Rodgers drops it to Jones in the flat, and from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short game.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Got a man, it's Tonyan. And he's going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
We couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, one score game, first and 10 here. Rodgers gonna throw. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Here's Rodgers. He'll get this to Lazard. And they're going to get this down to about the 37.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage. So timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. Finds his receiver, Watson, and able to get this to the 24-yard line. They began the play at the 12. It's also a pickup of 12 for the first down. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. Over the middle, complete. It's Cobb. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
They'll come up now on second and a yard. Rodgers to throw once more. Gets this to his running back, Aaron Jones. And the Packers are going to have a first and goal as the tackle made at the 10-yard line.
Well, they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
Might we see our first touchdown of the game? Here's first and goal. Now Rodgers. And he's got it. It's caught for a Packers touchdown. Aaron Jones from 10 yards out. And the Packers have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. Well, these two teams battled through a scoreless first half. Finally, a breakthrough here in quarter number three.
And I just wonder how that played for both of them psychologically, because when you battle through a scoreless first half, now you know that every possession is increasingly crucial. Who can put points on the board, make the other team chase? Wonder if you get a lift and if they get deflated a little bit.
Crosby with the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. After the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Taken in at the 3. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. So now a look at the Broncos as they head back out there for their first possession of the second half. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point. But it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back in this game.
They'll throw on first down with Wilson. And he will find his man, Sutton. That's complete. Finding room at midfield. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. It's a gain of 34.
And that might be exactly what they needed to wake up this home crowd. They haven't given much to cheer for so far. And never underestimate the effect the home crowd with you can have on a game.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. They'll run out of the gun here, Williams. And he's able to carve out about 6 there, down to the 37.
He's had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. From the shotgun, Wilson. A quick throw knocked away, it's incomplete.
Another attempt, another incompletion, and when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn into a long game or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points. And the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball.
Now Wilson. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Back-to-back incompletions of what was once a nice drive. Stalled out here. I'm going to give credit to the secondary partner. Never gave up as they gave up a few yards. And they came through on that play to deny that pass and force the fourth down.
The kick by McManus is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the response to that touchdown on the other side to begin the third quarter with just 3 points, but still a response nonetheless.
You're exactly right about that, because I think you needed to answer back with something, even though it's not 6. Just enough to send the message that says, hey, we're not going away.
After splitting the uprights, McManus to kick it away. Taken at the goal line. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive. Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
On second down, it's Jones. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Throwing is Rodgers. This is Lazard with a catch out left. Good gain on first, has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. From the shotgun, a give to Jones.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for the offense to go ahead and take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
You've got to be impressed by that defensive front on reps like those. They were not being moved off the line, kept their shoulders square, and gave their teammates time to fight to the ball and limit that gain.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Shotgun now for Rodgers. He's got the hookup with Dobbs. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. How about this? They'll try the option. Left side. Well, they needed 2. They could only get 1. 4th down.
And if you like defensive football, focus on the defensive end on this play. He does everything exactly right. Reads the play and makes sure he spills it for a small gain.
Here's Pat O'Donnell now as he's on to punt for Green Bay. And this will do the job nicely as that'll be out of bounds just inside the 10-yard line. 3 quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back now to Denver. It's the Broncos trailing, but they do have possession of the football as we begin quarter number 4. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. 2nd and 10. This run defense has been pretty stout all game long. Now you're here in the 4th quarter. Just rely more on the passing attack?
I don't think you have any choice, and I don't think you have to dress it up at all either. Throughout the first 3 quarters, you're still trying to convince the defense that you may run the football. That's out the window right now. Protect, let your quarterback operate, and try to find some targets in the open field, downfield. We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
The Broncos on 3rd down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This is 3rd and 10. Wilson. He'll find Sutton on the right side complete. And he will have the Broncos 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
And here we are in the 4th quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
On 1st and 10, it's Wilson. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the 1st down on a 13-yard run. Well, there you go. Save your best scramble of the day for a big-time situation in the 4th quarter, picking up the 1st.
You don't want to use it up early, right? You want to make sure you save it for that exact moment, that key time, and that's what he did, although you and I both know it wasn't planned that way. But what a nice job using his eyes, scanning the field, and realizing when it was time to exit the pocket and go.
Wilson's throw here into the hands of the receiver, Judy. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
Well, this is where reading defenses and practice time comes into play. You've got to know what you're running versus zone versus man and how to run the proper route. And they just executed that one pretty well.
Now Wilson on first down. That's complete. It's Greg Dulcich. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense. And guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
7 yards there and a first down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Throwing again here, Wilson. And his throw is incomplete.
But plain and simple, that's the second time today that he's dropped a pass.
And that one, I think, maybe even a little easier than the earlier one that he dropped. Surprising.
Was this game announced as a night game prior to it? Maybe his rhythm was just off. He's got thrown off. He's got to wake up, enjoy the sunshine, and go play.
To throw once more on second and 10. Wilson, he'll get this to Hamler over the middle. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 26. Give them 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward.
I love the drive they're working on here because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far on this drive, so good. They've moved the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively. But they better be prepared for some adjustments to come their way now.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. He'll get this one to Patrick. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. The end result, 21 yards.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field, and just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
With a touchdown, and that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Again, Wilson. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Russell Wilson, a 5-yard touchdown run, and the Broncos put together a fourth quarter drive to take the lead. Not the first time on this drive we saw him take matters into his own hands, and this time he finishes things off with a touchdown run.
You're not going to be happy with me, but I think he took matters into his own feet, didn't he?
No. Davis from the top rope. I like it. Now an important extra point here to stretch this lead to a field goal. He's got it, and this is indeed up to a 3-point lead. A pretty long drive that time, 11 plays all told. And it was Russell Wilson finishing things off with a touchdown run. To the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Taking in at the 3. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. We certainly have a good one on our hands. They're trailing after that last touchdown, but now a chance for this offense to try to snag that lead right back here in the fourth quarter. Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10 at their own 26. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. The throw complete to the tight end, Tonyan. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Looking to throw again on second down. Rodgers. Got a man, that's Lazard. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. They call his number again. It's his sixth catch and a first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
First down, Rodgers. He's got Tonyan complete over the middle. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then of course they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play. And that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 41. Here's Rodgers to throw. Over the middle here, it's hauled in by Watson. And they'll work this down inside the 30.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Three points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. And this will leave them a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
Rodgers in control as he hurries his guys to the line. He's back to throw. And the comeback may stall out. It's intercepted. Picked off by Pat Surtain. He's at the 40. The 20. Takes this one back into the end zone. And the Broncos defense has a touchdown. So they were in field goal range. Chance to go to overtime. Got greedy going for the win. Do you think maybe on the sideline they felt compelled to go for that win?
Sometimes that's what happens because as a head coach, you have to take the pulse of your team. You have to know where you are and how they're feeling. And maybe he thought, we've got to win it right now. Overtime, we might not have anything left for that. So maybe that's why they went for it and pressed it.
Unfortunately, it backfired. Now McManus to tack on the extra point. It's good to make it 17-7. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Keyshawn Nixon now from his end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So Aaron Rodgers and his offense down by 10, 80 seconds remaining. It's been a struggle to score all day, and now they need to do it twice here late to have a chance. Back to throw, Rodgers. It's complete, Lazard. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
That's a nice catch there. Remember, he had the fumble earlier. No way he was giving up the ball in that situation. Secured it tight to his body and picks up the first down.
First down now, but that clock rolling. Rodgers to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that is incomplete.
When you're leading in the final quarter, your radar has to be up for any potential deep shots. And probably not the last one they're going to see in this game, not as long as they hold this lead.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Now Rodgers. He'll find Lazard here over the middle. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
To throw is Rodgers. This is caught. It's Christian Watson. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. A check down here to Jones. And he'll be brought down at the 27. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Still 9 yards to go on second down from the 27. Rodgers now to throw. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
Give it big credit for his coverage right there, because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed in position to prevent a completion while avoiding any risk of a flag.
Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. Now Rodgers. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And the Broncos are going to take over once again at their own 37-yard line. All smiles and high fives on that defensive sideline. That interception will cap off what was truly a tremendous performance.
Yeah, if you can hold a team to 7 points in the NFL, that's the kind of day that you feel really good about. Now, I do know a few guys are going to think to themselves, held them to 7. If we'd made one more play, could have had our shutout.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. The win for the Broncos seemingly assured. They go down to a knee.
What a change in this ball game in the fourth quarter, Charles. They just completely took over, and not only did they get the lead, they end up winning somewhat comfortable.
And when we spent time talking with them before the game, they made sure that we knew that they thought that they were the better team in this one, and they never lost that thought. or lost that focus, and they played like it in the fourth quarter. That's how you offer a late comeback and get a win.